Hello everyone, this is TheSImPilot, and today is actually gonna be one of my most memorable flights, because it's like one day before my birthday, so this could be my birthday flight. So like, we are in the PMDG 737-800 right now. For some reason the jetway does not want to extend completely until our aircraft, so you're gonna see the passengers fall down from the jet bridge. It's not a big deal. But yeah, we are actually in the Jet Airways livery right now. This is an Indian Airlines that's basically dead at this point. It does not exist anymore. It faced some issues, but it was a very good, it was a very classical airline while it was there. They did do flights from Bombay and Delhi to Colombo, but our flight today is from Colombo to Hyderabad, which is a route that does not exist for their airline, so we're gonna be doing it instead. Alright, we are in the external view right now. We're actually under the terminal. I'm using Microsoft Flight Simulator's default scenery because I did not have the time to install custom scenery for this, and my internet speed is also very slow. So slow that in fact I had to disable photogrammetry, but it's alright. We can still fly for today. We can head into the cockpit right now. And I swear I had a RIS aligning. Alright, how long is it gonna take? 8 minutes. There's actually a problem in the PMDG 737 where you have to actually request data from SimBrief in your flight tablet, and then it's gonna load it into our flight computer, or else it won't work. Now if I did not load it into the flight tablet, it wouldn't show this SimBrief route option. So we can set fuel first. Transponder can be set to TA only. Alright, we can go and hit load now. It says route uplink loading. Okay, we can go ahead and open our SimBrief page right now, and we can go ahead and click fetch. So that's gonna do that. We can go into departure and arrival. Let's go back into route, I think. Okay, we can go ahead and activate. Okay, let's go into departure and arrival. So VCBI, our departure will be ATET1D. That's gonna be our departure. ATET1D. Alright, there you go. And departure runway is 22. That automatically selected. That's nice. We can also set our arrival now, so that we don't need to mess with the VNAV later on. LEDOB6. Okay, there you go. LEDOB6. And we can go ahead and choose ILS 27 left. For arrival, glide slope should be on. Alright, let's go check our legs and see if there are any discontinuities. There appear to be no discontinuities, so we can go ahead and request performance or request our performance initialization. Also appears that we need to do a hard bank to the left right after takeoff. That is going to be a little bit challenging, but we'll deal with it. It's alright. I am R.S. Vipuram, I can do it. Alright, we can go ahead and load this in. The cost index is 10 for this flight. Alright, N1 limit, it's actually not mentioned here. It's been so long, I've read the raw flight plan that I completely forgot what it all was for, but then it's alright. I hope our weather is set. It's live weather in real time. Is it 242? Oh yeah, it is 242, alright. I have lost absolute count of time. We can go with the flaps 15 takeoff. Oh, before I do that, let's go ahead and turn on our APU first, so that we can switch to our APU for ground power. We can turn on our fuel pumps. Have we got fuel in our center tank? Nope. Just fuel in our left and right. Alright. You're gonna see this rise. to until like 8 or 6 and then it's gonna fall back to 4. And then the APU gen bus transfer lights are gonna turn on, and then you have to hit those to, you know. Rotate speed is gonna be 140 knots for 15 degrees flaps. You can keep a QRH on, quick reference handbook. Our trim has already been set. We can set our departure heading. So it's 220 degrees. 140, 150, 180, 220, alright. And our cruise altitude, we're gonna be going directly to cruise. So flight level 380, so 38,000 feet. And we can directly set this to 180 because we need to accelerate after taking off too. And then we can go ahead and enable VNAV for further speed changes. We can go ahead and arm our auto throttles. Oh, sorry, auto throttle only one. Okay. Yaw damper. Okay, yaw damper. Where's yaw damper? Okay. There you go. Yaw damper is on. Window heat should be turned on too. I keep. Alright, I'm gonna plan a pushback and turn on an engines until our checklist is done as far as then. Yeah. Alright, I'll see you guys after pushback. Our APU bleed is on. Our APU bleed is on, and you can go ahead and turn on our starter for our left engine. We can set it to ground, and we should see this rise. It's not rising for some reason. Start valve is open. Something wrong. Our pushback is done. So we can go ahead and set our parking brakes. They're gonna lower the aircraft. Oh, okay. So we had to turn off our packs because the air conditioning was taking too much power away from the engine startup. Alright. We can start up our second engine at the same time too. We can set our ignition select to both so that we can start up both at the same time. Oh wait, but then this is 77. Alright. Oh, okay. Sometimes it's just the problems that the older aircraft have, especially when it comes to efficiency. Like, for example, you cannot start both engines on the 737 at the same time because its startup isn't electric, but then it's with compressed air. So yeah, if one engine takes away too much compressed air from the APU, then there wouldn't be enough for the second engine to start up. Alright, but our startup is complete. Our second engine is ramping up, and we can go ahead and set our flaps down to 15 degrees. It's just more camera, so it's better, more visible. 15 degrees set. Alright. Okay, now after both engines have started up. Alright, they're stable now. You can set this to continuous, and we can switch to our generators, can be switched to our engine generators, and we can also turn off our APU. It's not necessary to keep our APU turned on because it uses up fuel. Right, we can go ahead and okay, I have to map my throttle again. I disabled it for some reason. Alright, we can go ahead and disengage our parking brakes. We can set our throttle up so we can get that ground roll established. Our rudder is acting up. There's something wrong with my joystick. It's throwing complaints at me today. Alright, I'll see you guys after we taxi to the runway, and I'm gonna cut the recording right now. Alright, that was a very short taxi, but we are holding short of the runway right now. You can go ahead and turn on a runway turn off lights. Oh, and I forgot to turn these on too. Alright. And there appear to be no departing or arriving aircraft. Brake, 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 brake. Okay, there you go. Why is my throttle so sensitive? This is sort of goosebumps you get when you turn onto the runway. Alright, we are on the runway center line. We are configured for takeoff, so we can go ahead and hit and go ahead and input toga, which means takeoff and go around. So it gives the maximum amount of power the engine can give. Hold it, 80 knots, 100. Oh, this reset for some reason. V1 and you can go ahead and rotate. Okay, that was not a tail strike. We can go ahead with gear up. Alright, gear up. And we can initiate our bank to the. We can actually enable auto throttle and our VNAV. Oh, but then for that we have to engage autopilot. So we're just gonna do a right hand bank. Level stabilize and then enable autopilot. Alright, LNAV is enabled, VNAV can also be enabled, flight directors can be turned on. Please turn on. Alright, there you go. Oh, and we can go ahead with flaps up. Ooh, that was a very nice takeoff. At least it wasn't a tail strike like last time. Oh no, wait, I did not upload that video. I don't think I'll be uploading it anytime soon. We did not talk about what happened that time. I feel like my settings are a little bit oversaturated. My color settings, I'm using Nvidia filters and still cannot figure out what makes everyone's look so good. Reshade does not want to work on my Microsoft Flight Simulator for some reason. Even though I've reinstalled it so many times, it just does not want to work. That's a little bit too steep for a bank. I'm looking at our legs right now and it looks like a pretty relaxed climb. We're not going to be climbing that steep. Now we're parallel to the airport. There you go, that's Colombo International. Just zoom out and look at our entire route. Alright, I'll see you guys after reaching cruise. Our ascent is going pretty well right now. Alright, we are at cruise and we're just at the northern tip of Sri Lanka right now. In a while, we're going to be crossing over mainland India. There's not much of the flight left. We're almost like 40% done with it. I'll take some nice panorama shots and slap some music on and you guys can enjoy. And I'll see you guys at descent again. Alright, our descent has started. We are currently at 36,000 feet. We are gonna continue descending. Alright, I set our approach and everything. There was a discontinuity that I did not see. By discontinuity, I meant vectors, and it's, my aircraft can't really follow that, so I modified our flight plan a little bit to get a proper approach. Alright, I'll see you guys on short final. I'll do all the approach checklists first and then I'll see you guys. Alright, we are quite close to our airport right now and we have to decrease our airspeed a lot more. It's gonna go down to 185 where it flaps 1 right now. Our speed brakes are down to help us slow down faster. Oh yeah, and also my landing replay was on the whole time. So, you guys can see a very beautiful landing. If it goes well. Alright. I turned on my landing rate add-on too. It's called G's. It's free. And it's very nice. But it also gives me a reality check whenever I land. Like, I land terrible a lot of times. There's this one time where I had like a 90 FPM landing, I think, and that was the smoothest I had in the 737. Okay, all right, 165. We can set our auto brake to max auto. Rest of them, we don't need to do them now. Alright. We're going to be initiating a left-hand bank. Beautiful Hyderabad. I actually live there, so most of you guys will know that I actually live there. It's a very beautiful city. Our bank angle is going crazy. I hope our autopilot does not disengage. Landing altitude checked, recoil checked, auto brake set. Oh! Approach briefing is also complete. No, go up. There you go. Landing. Speed brake. Engines. Okay, they were in continuous thrust the whole time. Oh! I think I was supposed to set them to off. I don't remember that well though. Alright. Still at our approach phase, so that's no big deal. We're gonna have to do a left hand turn again, and then we can go and go ahead and intercept ILS. RFS LTL is still running, so we're gonna have ground traffic while we're landing. We should be aware of that. TCAS is on. Yeah, I'm pretty sure TCAS is on. Is TCAS on? Yeah. I changed it from TA only to transponder and radio altimeter too, because we need that while landing. Ooh, the bank. These are such steep banks, like I can see the ground. That's how steep these are. Like, I bet the passengers are probably being thrown around right now, but who cares? Alright, there you go. Now what we can do is we can go ahead and enable our, okay, now we need to descend to 3600 feet. Alright. Qualified for external overwater operations. So I guess I can cross oceans with this, but yeah. I think we can go ahead and enable our approach mode right now. Alright. And we can go and set our flaps to what we had to set it to. Let's go to our init ref, 40 degree flaps. 40 degree flaps. We can set our airspeed to 137 for now. Because plus 5 knots. So it's 130 plus 5, so it's 138. Our landing speed will be 138 knots. ILS has been intercepted, so we can also go ahead and put our gear down now. This is the right time to do it. I feel like we're a little bit too fast, but okay, 138. Let's just set that to 138. Arrival forecast. QNH 1009. That's set. Alright. Landing lights can be turned on. We have quite some fuel left. We are at 3300 feet. And I'll see you guys on short final.
A few moments later.
Alright, that was a pretty good landing. We did have other aircraft on the runway. Surprised that our our TCAS did not tell us anything about it, but it's a virtual aircraft, it'll do. 200 FPM landing was alright, it's alright, it's okay for daily operation. It's not smooth to say the least, but then it's doable. It's like the average Ryanair landing. That works for me. Alright, we can go ahead and enter the taxiway. This runway is not operational. So we don't need to worry about oncoming traffic. You know, I feel like I'm actually getting a lot higher frame rate this time with the PMDG 77 than what I got before. Like, it's hovering at like a stable 45 FPS for me, but then usually I get around 30. So it's a nice surprise, to say the least. And because of the better FPS that I was getting, our flight time wasn't longer than usual. There's this problem that, like, if you get a lower frame rate, then the sim runs slower than how it's actually supposed to run. Okay, there's an aircraft pushing back. I swear, if they push back to the left, we're screwed. There's so many Air India aircraft here. But then, usually for Rajiv Gandhi International Airport, you're gonna see more of Indigo aircraft. But here, there's more of Vistara and Air India. So that's a little bit surprising. Okay, what is that? Oh my god. No. What is that aircraft doing? Oh my god, okay, all did break. We have to go ahead and pull into our... looks like we're exactly on the center. That's very nice. Fortunately, we do not have a ground marshal with us. Okay, let's go ahead and set up parking brakes. We can go ahead and start our APU first. Engines can be turned off. Okay, our batteries are on. Wrong panel. You can go ahead and no, is the jetway not connecting? Oh, the jetway doesn't want to work. No, I think if you set a chalk, then it's gonna work. All right, we can switch our buses to APU Gen and turn these off. Turn off our landing lights. So I forgot to turn on our taxi lights after we landed, but okay, it's all right. We can turn these off too. We can turn off our APU. Turn off hydraulics off, probe heats and window heat off. APU bleed can be turned off, packs can be also turned off. Okay, packs have turned off automatically. All our lights can be turned off too, because we don't need our anti-collision lights because our APU isn't on. Fuel pumps can be turned off. Yaw damper can also be turned. No, okay, yaw damper is off. Alright, this has been a very nice flight, and thank you so much for staying with me today. Tomorrow is my birthday, and I'm really sure I'm gonna enjoy tomorrow. And I'm happy that I got to play once before my birthday. So this is the SimPilot.